Let us continue with illustration 12. 16 transactions we did yesterday.
Yes, sir.
Any doubts in illustration 11? Quite a simple illustration it works. Look at 17th transaction on page 77. We are continuing with illustration 12. Page 77. Transaction 17. Silence now. A machine purchased for rupees. Who is talking still in between? Yes, Shiv, what is the problem? A machine purchased for rupees 7000 and paid 500 cash for installation of machine. What note did we write regarding the purchase of assets? Expenses will be added in the cost, will not be recorded separately. And we did that yesterday for laptop also. Okay. So here we have purchased machine, means machine comes in. Here machine comes in, debit what comes in, machine account, debit. And we will write the amount including the expenses. Okay. So 7000 plus 500. The total cost of machine will be 7500. Any confusion in that? And further cash goes out, credit what? Goes out to cash account. But we will not record the expense separately. We will add it in the cost of asset. Did everyone understand this?
Yes.
Anyone who did not understand this 17th one? Then 18th. Goods of 300 received as free samples. Non-economic transaction. Simply write on non-economic transaction. Any confusion in this? Then, after deducting rupees 100 allowance, check issued to Royal Traders as, and then final settlement. Now understand one concept, and I'll make you write the note also for this. Whenever pull and final settlement takes place, always get the amounts from the solution, from the answer, not from the question. You'll always get the amounts from solution, answer, not from the question. And you simply have to obtain the difference of debit and credit. You see, in case of final settlement, obtain the amounts. From the solution. Are you okay with this? In which amounts difference of debit and
credit?
Write on the note. How many notes so far?
No.
9 notes?
Yes.
This is the 10th one? 11th one. Write on 11th note. In case of final settlement, comma, obtain the difference of debit and credit amounts in capital letters, write from the solution or answer. Okay, not see it from the question, you'll see it from the solution. Now, in this question, Do you find the settlement is done of royal traders? Now, royal traders. See the solution. In your notebook, see the solution, previous pages. Do you come across royal traders in fifth transaction in the solution? See the solution, everyone. In the fifth entry, do you have royal traders or not?
Yes.
In the fifth entry, do we have royal traders debit or credit?
Credit.
What amount?
27,000.
Do you get this? Then see, after fifth date in the solution, where do you come across royal traders? Eighth transaction. Is it debit or credit? Debit. What amount? So what we have to pay to royal traders is 26,000. This is what I made you write in the notebook. Obtain the difference of debit and credit amount from the solution. What does it mean actually? On fifth day, we purchased goods from royal traders of 27,000. On eighth day, we returned goods of 500 to royal traders. So now, how much amount you have to pay to him? 26,500. Okay. If you see in the question, you'll get 30,000. This is after deducting trade discount. Therefore, I said, don't see in the question, see in the solution. Then only you get the correct amounts. Okay. So whenever it comes to final settlement, what you will do? You'll see the solution and obtain the difference between debit and credit amounts. This is what the amount is to be settled. The amount is to be settled for what amount? 26? Now here it is given that after deducting 100 of allowance, we have issued check. Means what is the amount of check we would have given to royal traders? 26,400. After deducting 100 of allowance, what amount of check we would have given to royal traders? 26,400. Is everyone clear with this? At the top of your notebook, first show this workings. Understand it properly, because two transactions after this you'll try on your own. They are similar ones. Okay, so whenever you have to obtain the settlement, then you'll always see the solution and obtain the difference between debit and credit. So we have to settle what amount? 26,500. And after deducting 100, we have given check of what amount? 26,400. We are paying to royal, or royal is paying to us? Read the sentence, you'll easily come to know. Check is issued to royal traders. Means we are giving it to royal traders. Did you write this down? So who is royal traders? Receiver. Okay, royal traders is the receiver, debit the receiver. So royal traders account debit. Royal traders account you'll debit with full amount 26,500. Because you'll close this account. So you'll record it with full amount. Now we are giving check of what amount? 26,400 after deducting 100 of allowance. Check is issued. So bank is the giver. Credit the giver. To bank account 26,400. And what did I tell you regarding allowance and cash discount? Bank and cash. Bank we credit, so allowance also. Okay, allowance is the pet dog of bank. Wherever bank goes, it will follow, like the dog. So bank or cash you credit, then discount allowance also credit. Bank or cash you debit, then discount allowance also debit. Here bank is credited, so allowance also credit 100. Understood this portion, everyone? By the way, who is giving the allowance? We are giving to royal, or royal is giving to us? Royal is giving to us. It is our income. Credit all incomes and so to allowance. Is everyone clear with this? Try the next two on your own. Same procedure. See the solutions. 2021, try it on your own. Yeah. Vanshita, try it on your own. Get it?
Yes, sir.
Who else could get it? Okay, be attentive when I'm explaining the 20th, first this was 19. First I'm explaining the 20th. The settlement is of Nirali. So, very first, do you see in the solution Nirali is in transaction 9? In 9 there is a debit amount of 8100. And then on 13 there is a credit amount of
650.
Raise your hand who is not able to get this in the solution. 9th date there is a debit amount of 8100 against Nirali. 13th date there is a credit amount of 650 against Nirali. So that means we have to pay 7450. We have to receive. Okay, we have sold the goods. Again, 7450 Nirali has deducted 50 and given us the remaining amount. Is it mentioned cash or check is given? Means she has paid us? She is giving us the money. Okay, so cash comes in, debit what comes in, cash account debit 7400 50 rupees here, she has deducted per allowance. So cash coming in the business will be 7,400. Allowance is the dog of cash.
Yes.
Pet dog of cash. If cash you debit, then allowance account also you will debit. With 50? Yes, what happened? Who is speaking in between? By the way, we are giving allowance to Nirali. So allowance is our expense, debit or expenses and losses. And Nirali is the giver, credit the giver. To Nirali's account will close with full amount 7,450. Who will get this right? So anyone who is not clear with this? All are clear with this? Same way, 21st, there is a settlement of bombing. 21st. Now bombing you'll find very first in transaction 10.
Yes.
He is debited with 23,400. Okay, then you find it in transaction 15. He is credited with 11,700. Means the amount we have to receive from him is 11,700. Are you okay with this? Now here it is given that he has given cash of
5,000
and remaining by check. So check will be of 6,700. 11,700 minus 5,000 cash. So check will be of 6,700. Any confusion in this? Okay, now this is settlement of bombing. So on account bombing paid, cashed out 5,000 and issued check for remaining balance and settled the account. Now again, who is giving to whom? Bombing is giving to us. So cash comes in, debit what comes in? Cash account debit with 5,000. Further, he has given us check of 6,700. So bank is the receiver, debit the receiver. Bank account debit with 6,700. And bombing is the giver, credit the giver to Bhaumik's account with 11,700. Did all of you understand this? Anyone having any doubt in it? Who all could get both of them correct? Okay, now next one. Goods of 4,000 destroyed by fire. An insurance company admitted a claim of 3,000 and 200 realized from sale of destroyed goods. See, whenever such a transaction comes, you always start recording the things in reverse order. Means in the transaction, what is the last amount? Record that first. Then, record that. Then, record that. Whenever this goods destruction transaction comes, you start writing in which order? In reverse order. First, we'll give effect of that 200. Then, we'll give effect of 3,000, then will give effect of 4,000. Okay. What will be the effect of 200 realized by selling it for scrap? Cash comes in. 200 we have realized by selling it for cash. So cash comes in. Debit what? Comes in. Head on cash account, debit 200. Any doubts in this? After 200, which is the next amount in the reverse order? Now 3,000 insurance company has admitted the claim. So what is its effect? Yes, insurance claim is receivable. They have admitted the claim, not paid the claim yet. So repeat it. Insurance claim is receivable. Debit the receivables. So insurance company account debit with 3,000. Okay. Now, what is the value of goods destroyed?
4,000.
Against 4,000 we have recovered 3,200. So what is our loss?
800.
3,000 insurance company will give us, 200 we have already received by selling. So against 4,000 of goods destroyed, we have already recovered 3,200. So what is our loss?
800.
Loss occurs due to fire, debit all expenses and losses. So loss by fire account debit 800. Okay. And goods goes out. Credit what? Goes out. To purchases account 4000. Okay, goods of 4000 goes out of the business. Understood this? So always get the things in which order?
Reverse.
Any confusions in that? Anyone who wants to repeat it again? Next. 220% profit on selling price, goods of cost price 5000 sold. Market very, very important. And understand the concept first of all. Put your pens down. Very first of all, the important point here is, it is mentioned that 20% profit is on selling price. So far we have never come across such a thing. Like, even if you see profit questions earlier, transactions earlier, look at transaction 6. Goods purchased from Royal Traders, out of which goods of 15,000 sold to Bhagwati at 10% rate discount after adding 20% profit on it. Is it mentioned 20% profit on selling price? No. That means we have to count 20% of 15,000 itself, which is our cost price. We directly do 15,000 plus 20%. Transaction number 9. Goods of 15,000 after adding 20% profit. Is it mentioned 20% profit on selling price? No. So we directly count on 15,000 cost price. 15,000 plus 20%. 10th. Goods of 20,000 after adding 30% profit. Is it mentioned 30% profit on selling price? So we directly count 20,000 plus 30%. But in transaction 23, 220% profit on selling price. So can we do here 5,000 plus 20%? No. Because 5,000 is the cost price. And 20% profit we are earning on selling price. So you cannot count 20% of 5,000. And the problem is, we don't know the selling price, that is what we find. How can we count 20% profit on selling price when we don't know the selling price itself? And the profit is to be calculated on selling price. First of all, what is the meaning of this transaction? Understand it. Okay, suppose the cost price of goods is 8,000. Selling price is 10,000. So what is the profit you are earning? 2,000. Now, if you find out this 2,000 is what percentage of 8,000? We have done this calculation of percentage in past chapter statistics also. 20. So 2,000 is what percent of 8,000? Not doing petty. 2,000 divided by 8,000 into 100. That is 25%. Means 2,000 is 25% of 8,000. Cross check 8,000 into 25%. So 2,000 is 25% of which amount? 8,000 is the. So can I say this is 25% of cost price?
Yes.
Is it or not? Now same 2,000, if you find, it is what percentage of 10,000? How would you find? 2,000 divided by 10,000 into 100. What does it come to? 20%. Now this 20% is of what value? 10,000. Check it, 10,000 into 20%. Does it come to 2,000 or not? Means this 20% is of which value? What is 10,000? So can I say it is 20% on selling price? So the profit which you are earning, 20% on, you are earning 25% on cost price. Here it is given 20% on So, here in the question, 23rd transaction, it is given 20% profit is earned on?
Yes.
And what is 5,000?
Cost.
So, on cost price, is it 20% or 25%? 25%. If you want to add in 5,000, you should add which percentage? 25%. But then, how will we come to know that will it be 25? Suppose instead of 20, you are given 30%. Then how will you come to know what is the percentage of cost price? Or if you are given 15%, then how will you come to know what is it on cost price? So we will not be adopting this method. This I'm just explaining you the concept. Either the profit can be calculated as a percentage on
cost price,
or it can be calculated as a percentage on
sales.
When could we have done 5,000 plus 20%? When we could have done 5,000 plus 20%? When the percentage profit 20% was on
cost price.
Here we cannot do 5,000 plus 20% because it is on
selling price.
If you want to do 5,000 plus, then you have to do 25%, because same profit which is coming 20% of selling price is coming 25% of cost price. So if you want to do 5,000 plus, then you have to do 5,000 plus 25%. But again, the problem is, if it is a different percentage, then how to find in terms of cost price, it will be what amount? So there is a proper method of doing it. But is everyone clear with the meaning of on cost price and on selling price? Same profit, either you can express as percentage on cost price, or you can express it as percentage on selling price. When can we directly do the cost price plus the profit percentage? When it is on cost price. Or when nothing is mentioned means it's on cost price. Like we did in the earlier three transactions. But the problem here is it is on selling price. Okay, now how to do it? Understand it. Cost price plus profit is equal to selling price. We assume, suppose selling price is 100. Now why do we assume selling price is 100? Because profit is given 20% on selling price. In the question, profit is given 20% on
selling.
So we assume selling price as 100. And we go reverse. Okay, if it is given 20% on, then assume cost price as, but no need of that, then we can directly do 5,000 plus 20%. Then workings are not required only. Here, why do we take selling price as 100? Because 20% profit is given on selling price. Now, if you go reverse, then this plus will become? If you go reverse, then this plus will become minus. 100 minus profit is 20% on selling price. So, 100 is 20%, limit 20 only. So, what will be your cost price? 80. If you go reverse, then plus will become? Minus. So 100 minus profit of 20, what will be your cost price? 80. Now what is 5,000? Where should we write it? Against 80 or against 100? 5,000 is the cost price, so we should write it against 80. So what will be the selling price? How do you solve this equation? 5,000 into 100 divided by 80. 5,000 into 100 divided by 80. What is our selling price? 6,250. Now, what are we earning the profit here? What profit we are earning here? 6,250 and 5,000 cost price. What is the difference? 6,250 minus 5,000. What profit we are earning? There's a profit we are earning. And what is it given in the question? Profit is 20% on
selling
price. What selling price did we get?
26250
into 20%. Do you get the profit or not? So that 1250 profit is 20% of selling price, which comes to 6250. If you count on 5,000, then that 20% would become? If you count on 5,000, then same 20% would become 25%. On cost price, it would become 25%. Okay. So this workings will be done. This was just an explanation that same profit will be different percentage on cost price and different percentage on selling price. Now you do this workings along with me at the top of your notebook. How do you get the selling price? Cost price plus profit. Now we will go reverse. The profit is earned 20% on the profit is earned 20% on selling price. So what do you assume 100? Profit. Now if you go reverse, plus will become. So what would be cost 100 minus 20? Now in the question, what is 5000? So where should I write 5000 if it is a cost price? In front of 80. Okay, it's a cost price. And we are supposed to find what is the selling price. Now how would you solve this equation? 5000 into 100 upon 80. So 6250. All of you are clear with this? But when are you supposed to do this kind of working? Only when the profit is on selling price. If it is on cost price, then you can directly do the same. All right, everyone? Anyone who is not clear with this? Now, entry is very simple. Is any name given?
No.
Is it a cash transaction or credit?
Cash.
Cash transaction. Cash comes in. Debit what comes in? Cash account debit. And what is the money we will receive? 6250. Goods goes out. Credit what goes out? To sales account 6250. So everyone is clear with this complicated transaction? And when should you make this kind of workings? Only when percentage profit is on selling price. Okay? Next. Interest of 1 month paid on loan of Srimati. First let us pass the journal entry. Then we'll see this Srimati in detail. First of all, what is this interest on loan we are paying to Srimati? What is this interest on loan for us?
Expense.
Okay, interest on loan is an expense. Debit all expenses and losses. So interest on loan account debit. And we are paying that, so cash goes out. Credit what goes out? So cash account. Okay. Now look at date 2. How much loan was borrowed from Srimati? At what rate of interest? And look at date 24. For how many months we are paying the interest?
1 month.
And then 1 month. So 30,000 into 10% into 1 month. How will you count? 1/12. This we have done it earlier also. Then in homework also I gave you such questions when it was 6 months also, 5 months also. So 250. Count it, 30,000 into 10% into 1/12. Do you get 250 or not, everyone? If it was given 4 months, then what you would have done? 30,000 into 10% into 4/12. Is everyone up to play with this? Anyone having any doubt in that? 25. Goods destroyed in rail accident, 2500. What is it per business?
Loss.
Everyone is written this? Complete it, everyone. Raise your hand who is still writing 24. Now goods are destroyed in rail accidents. What is it for the business?
Loss.
Loss occurs due to accident, debit on expenses and losses. So loss by rail accident account debit. How much is that 2500?
Yes, sir.
And goods goes out, credit what goes out? To purchases account? 2500. Any confusion in this? All okay with it? Then 26. 50 shares of Adani Power Limited purchased at a market price of 300 per share and including 2% brokerage amount paid by NHA. This also I discussed with you in the notes that on assets and as well as on shares, whenever we purchase the shares and assets both, expenses will be directly added in the cost of shares. It will not be recorded separately. First of all, how many shares we are purchasing? So 50 shares into, what is the price? So that comes to plus 2% brokerage straight away you will add. We will have 50 shares into 300 rupees. You get 15,000. Directly doing calculator plus 2% brokerage. Do you get 15,300 or not, everyone?
Yes, sir.
So show it at the top, you know, for the calculation. Okay. Now, shares comes in. Debit what comes in? So investment in shares account debit. 15,300. And how did they pay the money? So bank is the giver, credit the giver, to bank account, 15,300. Is everyone clear with this? Any confusions up till here? Further, raise your hand who is still writing 26th entry. Complete everyone? Okay, 27. A computer of business 2500 sold to Karuna for rupees 1000. First of all, we discuss one more note. Whenever we sell the goods, we will not record. Whenever we sell goods, we will not separately record profit or loss because we directly count it at the end of the year. But whenever we sell assets, we will record the profit and loss immediately. Here, are we selling goods or assets?
Assets.
Computer is sold. Okay. So we'll record the profit or loss. 2500 computer sold for 1000. So profit or loss?
Loss
of 1500. First of all, we are selling it to Karuna. So Karuna is the receiver. Debit the receiver. Karuna's account debit. But from Karuna we have to receive only 1000 rupees. Okay. 2500 computer sold for 1000. So 1500 is our loss. Loss occurs due to sale of computer, debit all expenses and losses. So loss on sale of computer account debit with 1500 and computer goes out, credit what goes out, so two computer account 2500, computer of 2500 goes out. Did you understand this portion, everyone? Any doubts so far? 1028. Electricity bill and telephone bill of firm paid by check and then of firm. So what are both of them for the business?
Expense.
Debit all expenses and losses. Electricity bill is an expense. Debit all expenses and losses. So electricity bill account debit. The amount is 1800. Also, telephone bill is an expense. Debit all expenses and losses. So telephone bill account debit 700. And how did we pay both of them? So bank is the giver, credit the giver. To bank account 2500. Understood this everyone? Any doubt so far? What if it was given of the house instead of the firm? Drawings. Then personal expense, you will say owner is the receiver, debit the receiver, drawings account debit. Okay? Next. Bank has credited 200 for interest and debited 100 for bank charges. What shortcut did I make right for these things, bank interest and bank charges? What did I make right the shortcut for bank interest and bank charges? People don't remember only any notes. Identify the income or expense and give the opposite effect to bank account. Check this note is written or not. Okay, whenever there is bank charges and bank interest, easier way to get the journal entry is identify the expense or income and give the opposite effect to bank account. Do you find this note? Which number?
Four.
All of you read the fourth note, what is it? Shreyas, read it loudly, peer and dear. Fourth note.
If bank charges and bank interest transaction, identify the income or expense and give the opposite effect of that.
This is a simple way of doing it, shortcut way of doing it. Now tell me, first one is bank interest of 200. Is bank interest an expense or an income?
Income.
Income, credit all incomes and gains. So bank interest we do credit. So opposite effect, debit effect you'll give to which account? Bank account. Means bank account debit to bank interest account. The amount is 200. Understood that? Everyone? Okay. Same way, same date. We also have bank charges of 100. What is bank charges? Debit all expenses and losses, so bank charges account we will debit. So opposite effect, credit effect we will give to bank account. Okay, bank charges is an expense. Debit all expenses and losses. So bank charges account debit with 100. And opposite effect you will give to bank account with 100 rupees. Understood this? By the way, the complete effects and rules which are complicated to understand here, so we follow the shortcut. If interest is credited by the bank, then in our account the money will be received. So our bank account is the receiver, debit the receiver, bank account debit. And if bank charges are levied by the bank, they directly take the money from our account. So our account will be the giver. So our bank account is the giver, credit the giver to bank account. But here follow shortcut only. Otherwise you get confused because at first instance you will bank interest is received means bank is giving us the interest, so bank is the giver. But our account in the bank is the receiver. Okay, so easier way to remember, identify the expense and income and opposite effect you give it to bank. Okay? Goods of 500 stolen and 200 ruined in rain. So both are our loss. Debit all expenses and losses. So first, loss by theft account debit 500. Okay, loss occurs due to theft, debit all expenses and losses. Loss by theft account debit 500. Also loss occurs due to rain, debit all expenses and losses. So loss by rain account debit with 200. And goods goes out, credit what goes out to purchases account 700. Are you all okay with this? Everyone? Now suppose here it was given that goods of 100 rupees recovered after police inquiry. What you would have done?
Reverse.
Yes, you reverse it. I made you write one more rule. If you have to cancel or close any impacts, then reverse it. So what we would have done if goods of 100 are recovered by reverse, this means purchase account debit 100 to loss by theft account. Goods stolen will only be recovered. Police cannot recover the goods destroyed in raid. Okay, they are not becoming a bit dry and giving us back the goods after trying. These are destroyed only. So if it is given goods recovered back, they are the stolen ones only. And for raid, you will not do the FIR. So here, you will reverse these two things. You will reverse these two things means purchase account debit to 100 rupees to loss by theft, 100. You will cancel the impact with 100 rupees. Understood that? And the last one. Obtaining change of 1000 rupees, currency note of 100 was duplicated and nothing can be realized. Now 1000 is not possible. 2000 is possible. Suppose 2000 rupees pinky note, I give it to Amit. So I give pinky to me, pinky note of 2000. He gives me 3 notes of 500. And 5 notes of 100. In that 1 note of 100 is duplicate. So what is it for our business? Loss. Yes, silence. Then we also studied in that code transaction. Code ate the currency. Sundry loss. Silence over there. Whenever you cannot identify a specific reason to the loss, you will say sundry loss. So right now, loss occurs in the business. Yes. Why are you talking so much, Jay? Loss occurs in the business. Debit all expenses and losses. So sundry loss account debit with 100 is our loss. And cash goes out, credit what goes out to cash account 100. Is everyone clear with this? Totals, homework, you can do it on your own. Okay. Now, be attentive. What you will be doing here, homework, understand it carefully first of all. Put your pens down. Accounting equation and business transactions. Yes, silence. It is a small chapter, it will be over in one lecture itself. So listen carefully what you have to do in homework tomorrow, understand the things properly. What is the accounting equation? Accounting equation is an equation of balance sheet which you will actually study in detail in second part of accounting. It's a useless chapter which is kept in first part of accounts. But because it is there, we have to cover it, otherwise as such, without the knowledge of this chapter also, when we come to part 2 of accounts, you will be able to follow what is going on in that chapter. And this all you are going to forget by that point. But accounting equation is, assets are equal to capital plus liabilities. This is called accounting equation. Assets are equal to capital plus liabilities. Now, how we will be doing? Stand up. Are you? Now, how we will be doing is, if you don't have in syllabus, I know, but GRM is hazard.
सर और फिल्म का पर्सनल
यस
जैसा परसों टेस्ट है
सो यस लिसन केयरफुली एवरीवन असेट्स इक्वल्स टू कैपिटल प्लस लायबिलिटीज इज एन अकाउंटिंग इक्वेशन एंड हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डू द सॉल्यूशंस ऑफ दिस चैप्टर इज वी आर गोइंग टू यूज टू पेजेस साइमल्टेनियसली means our solution will be done in both these pages at the same time okay so suppose this is yes now if anyone is speaking then illustration will be done that by that person 12 times after the class here itself complete silence now no one will be speaking in between suppose this is the left side of your page and this is the right side of your page okay the other side left side and right side now here you pass the journal entries without the column of LF and without the narrations okay so you'll have the columns of date particulars debit and credit okay right side of the page will require effects assets capital and liabilities these we will require on the right side of the page so two pages are to be used simultaneously okay now chapter 4 Exercise 2, page number 107, page number 107, exercise 2, do you mind 19 transactions in that?
Yes.
What I want is, in the classwork notebook itself not in the homework notebook journal is done in this chapter
yes,
so instead of doing journal's homework for tomorrow this exercise 2 of chapter 4 page 107 19 transactions journal entries you pass it from momentum because journal entries are already clear I just need to explain you in this chapter how to do this assets equal to capital plus so if you do that journal from home and come this we can do in the class there's only one question and exercise and the chapter will be over tomorrow are you okay with this portion so we'll not be wasting much time on that and it's related to journals so we finish it right now what is not required here is the column of and narrations but one more thing we have to do When you pass the journal entries, leave 8 lines for each journal entry. 8 to 10 lines, minimum 8. Means, like your journal entry has only 2 lines. 6 lines, leave it blank. 6 lines, leave it blank. Then pass the next journal entry. Every journal entry you leave 8 lines total minimum 8 lines otherwise you'll have trouble in solution tomorrow got it everyone write down this in the notebook chapter 4 equation of assets and liabilities and this thing in classwork notebook itself the journal of exercise 2 you will write and down okay Exactly.